बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज़ मोहम्मद फुरकान। विजुअल रिप्रेजेंटेशंस हेल्प अस टू अंडरस्टैंड डेटा क्विकली। वेदर यू आर कंपेयरिंग स्टूडेंट्स परफॉर्मेंस इन एग्जाम्स और हाईलाइटिंग अ ट्रेंड, व्हेन यू शो योर ग्राफ्स एंड चार्ट्स, योर प्रेजेंटेशंस एंड रिपोर्ट्स बिकम मोर क्लियर एंड अफेक्टिव। द ग्राफ्स एंड चार्ट्स आर द विजुअल्स दैट शो द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन डेटा। They make it easier for people to understand information. Pie chart, line chart, bar graph and histograms are the types of charts and graphs. Today we will discuss pie chart. A pie chart compares parts to a whole. As such, it shows percentage distribution. A pie represents the total of a data set and the pie slices are the portions of a whole. Charts and graphs are widely used in businesses, mass media and in schools. In businesses, we can use it to show the failure and the success of a business or the market segment of a company. In schools, we can use it to show the number of students present in each class or the performance of a student in exams. So let's learn how to understand and construct a pie chart. So dear students, the table shows the performance of the students of a class in a exam. 12 students got A grade, 15 students B grade, 8 students C grade and 5 students D grade. In order to construct a pie chart, we need two things. First is degree and second one is percentage. We can construct a pie chart without percentage, only with degree, but when we present the data with percentage, it will be more easier for us to understand information. So let's start first of all calculating degree and percentage. Let's calculate how many total students are there. There are 12 plus 8, 20 and 15 plus 5, 20. 20 plus 20, 40 students. As we know, the total rotation of a circle is equal to 360 degree. Divide 360 by the total amount you have calculated. The total number of students are 40. When you divide 360 by 40, this will be 4 ones are 4 and 4 nines are 9 degree. Now multiply each number with 12 multiplied by 9, multiplied by 9, multiplied by 9, and multiplied by 9. Now 12 nines are 108 degree, 15 nines are 135 degree, 8 nines are 72 degree, and 5 nines are 45 degree. The total of this will be 360 degree. Now calculate the percentage. As we know, formula to calculate percentage is part upon whole multiplied by 100. So the part is 12 here for grade A students and total is 40. 12 divided by 40 multiplied by 100 is equal to 30% of the student got A grades. Now 20% and 12.5%. So 100%. Now we have calculated degrees and percentage. Now we can easily construct a pie chart. In order to construct a pie chart, we need a circle. Draw a circle first of all. Then the point in the center of a circle is called the center point. First of all, draw a line from the center of a circle to its border. Now we will construct a pie slice for the
students who secured A grades is of 108 degrees. So we will construct a pie chart of 108 degrees. So place a scale and make sure that your scale is matching the line. Often the students get confused which scale is to use, either to use top scale or bottom scale. Dear student, always use start from the zero. So I am starting. We have to construct this pie slice of 108 degrees. So 0, 10 degree, 20, 90 degree, 100 degrees, 100, and this will there it will be 108 degrees. Now after placing a point, draw a margin, draw a line between to this point. So 108, 30% of the students of a class got A grades. Now we will construct a pie slice for the student who secured A grade. This will be of 135 degrees. So start again, place a scale protractor on this circle starting from zero again. And this is here, it is 135 degree. Percent of the students got B grades. Now third one is 72 degree. So again, starting from zero, this is where it is 72 degrees. And this is understood that it would be of 45 degrees. Twenty percent of the students secured C grade and 12.5% of the students secured D grades. We can also write the number of students like 12, 15, 8 in the pie chart, or if you want to write it on outside of the pie chart, you can write it here like 12 students, or this is 15, this is 8, and this is 5. You can also fill the different colors in this pie chart. Now we can see that we can easily understand it from information from this pie chart. So dear students, the table shows the number of students who travel to the school by different ways daily. 45 students travel by bus, 25 students by walk, 20 students by train, and 10 students by car. So first of all, calculate the total number of students. The total number of students are 100. As we know, the total rotation of any circle is equal to 360 degrees. Divide 360 by the total number or the total amount. Here the total number of students are 100. So when you divide 360 by 100, this will be equal to 3.6. Now multiply each number with 3.6, 3.6, and 3.6. When you multiply 45 with 3.6, this will be equal to 162 degree, and 25 with 3.6, 90 degree, 3.6 is equal to 72 degrees, and 10 multiply with 3.6 will be equal to 36 degree. So when you add them together, this will be equal to 360 degree. Now percentage, how to calculate percentage? It's quite easy. The part is 45 and the total is 100. when the total is 100, the percentage will remain same as part 45 divided by 100 multiplied by 100. This 100 will cancel this 100, and this will be 45%, and as it is, this will be 25%, 20%, and 10%. Now, first of all, we will construct a pie slice for the students who travel by bus, and its degree is 162 degrees. So place a protector on the circle. Make sure your scale is matching the line, and always start from 0 0. This is 100, this is 150 160, and here it is 162 degrees. And percent of the students travel by bus. Now second one is by walk. This is of this sector is of 90 degree, so match the line. Here it is 90 degree, and students walk to the school. 25% students walk to the school. Now 72 degrees, and here it is 72 degrees. Students travel by train, and this is last one understood. This would be 36 degree, and 10% student travel by car. Now, instead of reading this big list, we can easily understand the information from this pie chart. 45% of the students travel by bus, 25% walk to the school, and 20% travel by train, and 10% travel by car. I hope the concept of pie chart is now clear to you, and this video will help you in understanding and constructing pie chart. Keep practicing at home. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum.